Couple wins $60 million, 5 years later ask police to destroy home. Casey looks around her dream home, and she feels sick to her stomach. She hears the sound of high-pitched squeaks and a terrible smell lingers in the air. Like rotting flesh, Casey can taste it now on the tip of her tongue, as she walks through her new 7-bedroom mansion. Casey and her boyfriend Matt thought all their problems would have been solved by winning the lottery. But they were so wrong. You see, their problems had only just begun. Lovebirds Matt Topham and Cassie Carrington were an ordinary couple from a small town in England. Although the couple was deeply and madly in love, nothing exciting ever really happened in their lives. Every day seemed the same. So when these two lovebirds entered a jackpot for $60 million at their local town, never in their wildest dreams did they think they would get so lucky. To make ends meet, Matt worked as a carpenter and Casey worked at her local supermarket. The two were more than content with their lives in their one-bedroom apartment just outside of the town. It was small but cozy. But little did these two lovebirds know that fate had something else in store for them. It was a brand new week and both Matt and Casey went to their local shop. After picking up some bread and milk, Casey noticed that this week's lottery was for $60 million. She looked at Matt and quickly she filled in a lottery card with their lucky numbers. Casey and Matt didn't do the lottery every week, just when they felt like it. They had never won anything big before either, merely a crisp $10 bill. But Casey had a gut feeling that was telling her to enter the lottery. Casey filled in her numbers and handed them to the cashier. She didn't think anything of it. If she was going to win anything, it would probably just be $10, maybe even $20. It was only later that night when the lottery numbers were announced that Casey and Matt's biggest dream had come true. Later that night, Casey and Matt were sat around her television waiting for the jackpot numbers to be announced. Casey's eyes were fixated on the screen and her ears perked up when she heard the winning numbers. 7, 28, 25, 5, and 17. Casey couldn't speak. Her mouth dropped wide open and her heart began to race. Those were her numbers. She and Matt had won. Casey and Matt ran into each other's arms with happy tears streaming down their face. $60 million was all theirs. It wasn't hard for them to come up with things to spend the money on. They would obviously take care of their family and go on vacation, probably get a new car, definitely a new house. This couple thought all their problems had been solved. But they had no idea that this was the start of something truly unimaginable. The first thing that the happy couple did with their winnings was buy a 7-bedroom mansion for about $1.6 million. The mansion was everything they were looking for. For many people in their town, this 7-bedroom mansion would be a dream come true, but for Matt and Casey, it was only the start of a horrific nightmare. Although the mansion was all theirs, when Matt and Casey bought it, they didn't move in straight away. You see, they planned to do work to it, to renovate and customize it. The total cost for this project would be just over $6 million. But with still around $60 million in the bank, a mere $6 million looked like nothing. They had no idea what was coming. Matt and Casey called their new mansion Serenity, but their plans and projects for the mansion were far from calming and peaceful. They had goals of adding a second house to the property, building a 10-car garage as well as a swimming pool. Their plans were foolproof. Or so they thought. Even though Matt and Casey's plans for the mansion were big and bold, they were confident they would be able to accomplish them. After all, with millions of dollars in the bank, what could go wrong? Matt and Casey soon got to work on their big and grand project, but their renovations soon came to an abrupt halt. With so much money in their bank, this was such a strange yet incredible experience for the young couple. Not only did they purchase the mansion, but they also bought another home, specifically for their closest friends and family. They also went on numerous luxurious vacations to New York, Japan, and France. Then, a year after they first won the lottery, Casey had some news that would change everything. Just when Casey and Matt thought life couldn't get any better, Casey found out she was pregnant. The two soon-to-be parents swiftly tied the knot and finally, this family felt complete. While Casey and Matt were having the times of their lives with their new fortune, the couple had completely neglected their dream mansion. They had no idea what state it was in. UC Casey and Matt's mansion had become a sight for sore eyes. Trespassers were constantly breaking into it, and police from the town often made trips to the mansion to keep vandals and criminals away. The mansion itself was originally built in the 1930s. Throughout the town, it was known as the Rainbow House. But after Casey and Matt bought it, it soon became a house of horrors. Neighbors of the mansion were constantly complaining about the property. From the untidy and unkempt garden to the offensive graffiti that covered the mansion's exterior. But criminals and vandals were not the only unwanted guests at this perfect mansion. When Casey and Matt went back to the mansion to see what all the uproar was about, they were disgusted to see it in such a state. Toilets were smashed up, dead animals were scattered everywhere, and rats and other creatures were running wild. The entire house was a death trap and a serious health and safety hazard. Neighbors were angry at Casey and Matt for letting it get this bad. But things were about to get even worse. You see, many children and teens in the area had called the mansion the scariest place to take a selfie in all of the town. Casey and Matt knew they couldn't carry on like this anymore. They both knew what they had to do, but neither of them would admit it. Casey rang her local police station and asked them to come and demolish the entire mansion and property before it got even worse. Inevitably, Casey and Matt were heartbroken knowing that would never get to transform their dream mansion. But this didn't mean their dreams of living a luxurious and celebrity-style life was over. You see, the couple still owned the land, so they planned to build a brand new home on the site. Casey and Matt presented the council with their updated plans for their new home. As of now, they're still waiting for permission, but they're confident it'll go through. When it comes to their new home this time, the lucky couple has promised to keep an eye on their property every single step of the journey.